was also there to file paperwork for the Buttigieg campaign endorsing his campaign for president in a year where mayoral endorsements could potentially make a difference in the race for president and in other races on the ballot. Our Kayla Sullivan has more.
So with great pride and with pleasure, I join with all of the volunteers who have worked so hard to put Pete's name on the ballot in the state of Indiana for the presidency of the United States.
Indianapolis Mayor Joe Hogsett's endorsement is big for presidential candidate Pete Buttigieg in Indiana.
Indiana may be a decisive state come May with our primary. And also, Hogsett is the mayor of the 16th largest state in the country, one of the biggest mayors so far to endorse Pete Buttigieg.
Mayors endorsing candidates in general is becoming more popular.
They're seen as sort of bipartisan, nonpartisan figures who really control a lot of political machinery within their own cities that can really help get out the vote on Election Day.
Republican Kelly Mitchell filed for the 5th Congressional District in Indiana. She says the fact she has mayoral support from her area is crucial to her campaign.
Well, it's incredibly important. I mean, the 5th District is the place I'll represent in D.C., and so I need to know what's on the ground here. You know, I need to know what's happening here. I need to know the issues. I need to know the cares, because I represent those in D.C. So it's not at all a distant connection. It's very, very close, and it needs to remain so.
The majority of people who participated in our Twitter polls say a mayor's endorsement doesn't matter, but 30% say it depends on the mayor.
Mayors connect with people. The people in your city don't care if you are a Democrat or Republican. They only care if there is a pothole in front of their house.
Kayla Sullivan, Fox 59 News.
Meantime, coming up, we're also hearing from another nearby mayor who's endorsing former Mayor Mike Bloomberg, with both former mayors in this presidential race really going after those mayoral endorsements all across the country. Meantime, Mayor Hogsett facing criticism this week, dealing with a tragic quadruple murder just a day after the Democratic-led council rejected a Republican proposal to create a bipartisan commission to study violence.
The idea that if we only had one more bureaucratic entity studying violence, then our problems would be solved. That is ludicrous.
Where's the action, and where's our leaders? And so I look forward to seeing it today. I was hopeful to see it this morning, and it was made clear they have no plan.
Now the FOP president and four area ministers are creating their own citizens commission on criminal justice. Up next this Sunday in Focus, we're talking with our panel about the State of the Union, the speech itself, but also the state of our nation, so incredibly divided in this election year. We'll talk about that, and we'll take you to the Statehouse, where lawmakers return tomorrow for the second half of the legislative session. We're back after this.